You just saw the first male half marathoner come in just a little bit ago, Morsi Rayan, based out of Ann Arbor. We had the first female, Emily Oren, from Hillsdale College. So we got some locals here, and right now we're also joined by the regional president of Chemical Bank. Now, Jim, I know you've run before, and this time it's almost a little bit more nerve-wracking, right? Because your wife is running today.
Yes, correct. Yeah. I'm sure she's doing great out there, and I'll look forward to seeing her very soon.
And what's it going to be like when she crosses the line? Because you're a runner. You've run this before. What do you say at the end of that race?
It's a great accomplishment, right? Because there's been a lot of training and dedication for all of these people. And we have about 250 runners from the bank as well, from Chemical Bank. So we're excited to sort of see all those people finish and the dedication they put into.
And I know earlier we talked to one of your employees who was going to run the half. Unfortunately, you guys had a death in Ohio, and he stepped up to the plate. It seems like that's what you guys are really about, pulling together for that. Is that why you guys get so involved with this?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, community immersion is one of our key pillars. So being involved in our communities, we have an office here in Detroit, a branch. Here in the state of Michigan, we have over 200 branches. So almost 3,000 employees, so very dedicated to the community and really have an appreciation for that.
I know right now Mike is getting a picture of some of these runners crossing the line. It's one thing to talk about this, but when you see what you guys have put into this come to fruition, what does it mean to you?
Yeah, I mean, to me it gives me goosebumps, quite honestly. I mean, seeing these people, how hard they've worked and the dedication, it's really fantastic.
All right, Jim, we appreciate you taking the time speaking with us this morning. Hey, we're going to keep on top of this, and we're going to show you guys some of the top finishers in all the different categories throughout the morning. Continue to follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and we will continue to bring you the latest stories from right here in downtown at the finish line of the Detroit Free Press Marathon. We'll send it back to you guys in the studio.